Hello students, myself Sujata, lecturer of ENC department from Government Polytechnic Nagmangala. I welcome you all for today's session, which is session 10, the continuation of logistic management system, what we had learned in session 9 of unit 2, production and material management from the course organizational management and entrepreneurship of fifth semester diploma organized by the Department of Collegiate and Technical Education, Electronics and Communication Engineering Board. In the last class, we had understood about the necessity of doing codification for the materials in the stores or in an inventory. And we had also seen the various methods we had used for doing this codification. Codification, as we know that, it's a process of assigning a unique identification number to the raw materials in the stores or in an inventory. And the methods what we had discussed was, the first method was alphabet or letter code or mnemonic system, where in this class a specific alphabetic code or the letter code will be used to denote the particular classes of materials. And the next method was simple numeric or sequence system. As the name indicates, a specific number would be assigned to the raw materials of some specific size, followed by the sequence numbers of different sizes. But the disadvantage in this system was that it is impossible to memorize the complete sequence of numbers of raw materials of different sizes. Every time we have to look back into the material code book to get the sequence number or the code number of that particular raw material. And the next system was numeric system or group system. Here, some basic digit will be assigned to certain raw materials. And the raw materials will then be followed by the dimension of it. So it's a combination of both basic digit as well as the dimension. The advantage in this system is, if we know the basic digit, then the raw material can be easily identified based on the dimension of it. And the next system was decimal system. In the decimal system, both integer as well as decimal part will be used to indicate the classification of materials. For example, integer represents the basic unit, whereas the decimal part represents the subunit of it. And in the next system, block system, where a sequence of block numbers will be used. For example, 5000 to 5049, this block represents raw materials. 5050 to 5099, this block represents the components, and so on. And the last system was combination system, where we are combining both mnemonic as well as numeric or decimal system. So these were some of the methods we had studied for doing codification on the raw materials. We had also seen the advantages of doing this codification and the principles to be followed before doing the codification in stores management system. At last, we had learned about logistic management system, where different logistic units we had seen and the components of complete logistic management system as a part of supply chain management system. We had seen it in detail. In today's class, let us continue some more topics on logistic management system. These are the topics for today's discussion. We are aware of some common means of transportation we are using in our day-to-day lives, for moving from one place to another or for moving the goods from one place to another. Here, we are understanding the different means of transportation used in the logistic management perspective. Then, let us understand the functions of doing packaging for the transportation and the benefits we are going to get out of good packaging in the logistic management system. Also, we will come to know about different material handling equipments which are used during shipment of goods to the transport vehicle. Next, we'll see the causes or the advantages of having good routing during transportation of goods to the delivery station, and also the impact of improper routing in terms of delay and its effects. Next, any cargo or goods on transit in logistic management will be in the need of safety and security against the money that is tied with those materials. And this can be accomplished by buying the insurance on the goods which are in transit. Let us understand the necessity of buying the insurance in brief. Next, the references to be followed for today's topics. And lastly, it's the time to assess our knowledge on today's topic with some objective assessment questions. Firstly, we'll understand the different means of transportation used in logistic management system. As we know, transportation is the movement of people or goods from one location to another. The different means of transportation used for logistic management purposes are listed out here. Let us understand in brief one by one. Firstly, human powered. It is the transport of people or goods using human muscle power, that is in the form of walking, running and swimming. For example, we can transport people or goods through bicycles with the human efforts for pedaling. And the next means of transport is animal powered. It is the transportation of people or goods by using animal powered transports. For example, we can make use of bullock carts or horses to carry the goods or people from one place to another. Then, air means of transport. Here, we can transport people or goods through aeroplane or helicopters or aircrafts. Then, rail transport. Here, the transportation of people or goods happens through passenger express or goods trains. The next means of transport is road transport. Here, the transportation of people or goods happens through some automobiles like buses, trucks, motorcycles, etc. The next means of transport is water transport. Here, we are transporting the people or goods through water crafts such as boat, ship or sailboats. There are other means of transportation used for logistic purposes. Some of them are listed out here. The first transport is pipeline. It sends goods through pipe-like gases and liquids. It uses two types of systems, short distance systems, which are used for sewage purpose, mainly drainage system or for slurry. Slurry means a mixture of manure and water. Usually it would be used by farmers as a natural fertilizer for their crops. While long distance systems are used for petroleum and natural gases. The next transport is cable transport. It is a broad mode where vehicles are pulled by the cables. For example, we have seen elevators, escalators, conveyors, etc., which are all pulled by the cables for their movements. And the next system is space flight, which transport Earth's atmosphere into outer space by the use of spacecraft. These are some of the commonly used modes of transportation in logistic management system. Next is packaging. Packaging means wrapping of products to make them safe from damages during transportation and storage. It keeps the product safe and marketable and also helps in identifying, describing and promoting the product as well. Let us see the functions of packaging in logistic management system. This packaging is an important activity in transportation and material management. It is closely tied to transportation efficiency and effectiveness as well. Best packaging, as we know, that always increases the services and it decreases the transportation cost and it improves handling charges or handling procedure as well. Good packaging can also have a positive impact on transportation productivity. Packaging takes up space and adds weight, but in industries, packaging is used to get benefits by reducing its disadvantages of added space and weight. There are two main functions of packaging which are listed out here. Firstly, marketing. Here, the package provides customers an attraction with the information about the product, and it also promotes the product through the use of color and shape. Secondly, logistics. From logistic perspective, the packaging is to organize, protect, and identify product and materials. These are the two main functions of packaging in the perspective of marketing and logistic units. Let us now understand the benefits of having good packing in logistic management. Lighter packing may always save transportation cost, as the transportation always depends on the weight of the goods being transported. Then careful planning of packaging size or cube provides better space utilization of transportation. More protective packing may always reduces the damages on the goods, and the requirements for special handling in transportation will be reduced. Good packaging reduces the shipping and storage cost. Good packaging increases effective handling of goods. Best packaging increases services, decreases cost, and it improves handling. These are some of the benefits that we are going to get with good packing in logistic management on the goods which are in transit. Next topic is material handling, which basically prepares the items for shipment and loads them into transport vehicle. Material handling plays an important role in logistic management system. Here, both powered and non-powered equipments are used for material handling in logistic management. Here, the order picker can use a large selection of powered and non-powered equipments for transportation, and then can sort those items located in racks, shelves, and drawers. For example, this type of apparatus includes forklift trucks. Forklift trucks means these are the trucks used for lifting and carrying heavy loads. We can use platform trucks for transporting goods in platforms to transport vehicle. And we can also use hand trucks for transporting goods for shorter distance to the shipment vehicle. And we can use cranes and carts, etc. Shipping of products to the customer involves preparing items for the shipment and then loading them into the transport vehicle. The material handling equipments used for this purposes are pallets, palletizers. Pallets antare halagegalu. Then we can use strapping machines, means the machines used for keeping boxes, packages and bundles which are held tightly. And we can also use stretch wrappers. Stretch wrappers means the item which is stretchable plastic film which is wrapped tightly around the items. So these are some of the material handling equipments used for shipment purposes to the transport vehicle. Next, let us understand the importance of routing in logistic management. In transportation, the routing can be defined as the selection of paths or the routes over which each vehicle is to travel from the point of the receiving station to the delivery station for the purpose of customer satisfaction. Good routing, it always increases customer services and gain profits as well. As it is self-explanatory, selecting the routing path is very much important in transporting the goods from the receiving station to the delivery station, basically to meet the customer services requirements. Nowadays, the effective and efficient routing is very important due to the increased competition and deregulation. Hence, there is a greater demand to reduce the economic factors like fuel, labor, and equipment needs as well. So hence, there is a need to optimize the routing. Optimizing this routing, it always reduces the transportation cost and increases the productivity. But sometimes it is better to use fixed routes instead of variable routes for some shipments where the carrier will have a larger delivery time window, and thus it can improve vehicle utilization and reduces some equipment costs as well on a per delivery basis. These are some of the benefits we get with the utilization of proper routing. However, now let us see the impacts with improper routing as well. Improper or improved routing, as we know, always reduces the delays in transportation of goods to the delivery station. But with improper routing, the delay in good transportation increases, which leads to increased transportation cost and it reduces the productivity as well. Delays in transportation reduces customer services and it also increases the material handling and maintenance cost as well. Hence, choosing of the route paths in transportation of goods is very important, as there is always a dependency of delay causes on routing. Next, let us understand about demurrage charges. When a cargo arrives at a terminal, it is given certain amount of time that it can stay there for free before it needs to be moved out. Demurrage, which is sometimes referred to as storage, and is the charge terminal places on the shipment if it is held up at the terminal for some reason, like basically awaiting transportation, there is a need to clear customs, etc., after the free time has expired. So this demurrage charges, we can say that, which are effectively penalty charges to be paid if any delay happens during loading or unloading of the goods sitting for a longer time at the terminal. That is, it is a charge for undue detention of goods. The demurrage charges is inclusive of all these charges. Some of them are capital cost or opportunity cost. This cost is nothing but this is the return that the company could make on the money that it has tied up in inventory. Next is inventory service cost. This includes insurance and taxes on inventory. Next is storage space cost. It is self-explanatory, the cost incurred for storage purpose. And next is inventory risk cost. This includes obsolescence. Obsolescence means for the cost incurred for the material which is no longer used, or pilferage, the cost incurred on the materials which are stolen or damaged, and for the relocated materials within the inventory system and the damaged items. So these are all the cost comes under demurrage charges. Once the shipment runs into demurrage charges, terminals will expect to settle the cost quickly, and the cost can mount up quickly. Hence, precautions must be taken to get rid of demurrage charges by moving out of the terminal in the stipulated time given. Now, let us understand the last topic in logistic management system about buying the insurance on cargo during transit. Insurance is a system of protection against loss under which number of parties agrees to pay certain premiums for a guarantee that they will be compensated under certain condition for the specific loss and damage that has occurred on the materials. This is done to claim the damages against the natural disaster that may happen accidentally, leading to the loss of goods or materials. Logistic activities always requires to buy the insurance over the materials which it stores or transports. That is to have a safety and security against the money tied with that materials which the companies are managing. There are many insurance companies who come forward to make the insurance by taking cost related premium from the transportation companies. Insurance certificate is a document issued to the consignee that covers the loss or damage to the cargo while in transit. Hence, we can conclude that insurance is very much essential for the materials to have a safety and security on those while in transit. These are the topics for today. Next, we'll see the books to be referred to understand the topics covered so far to get more information about them. We can refer Organization Management and Entrepreneurship textbook with any of the following authors, that is P.G. Mundas, V.S. Bhagat, Rajesh Hongal, B.A. Srinivas to get more information about the topics. Now, the time to assess ourselves on the topics what we had learned so far with some of the objective questions. Let us be ready and let us start with the questions. First question, dash is an important activity in transportation and material management. Option A, purchasing. Option B, logistics. Option C, packaging. Option D, routing. Students, as we know that it is obvious that packaging is an important activity in transportation, as good packing offers lot of advantages which we have already discussed. Hence, option C, packaging, is correct for question number 1. Question number 2, the function of packaging is marketing, option B, logistics, option C, routing, option D, both A and B. We had seen that there are two main functions of packaging, that is marketing and logistics. Hence, option D, which says both A and B, is correct. Question number 3, benefits of packaging are option A, save transportation cost. Option B, better space utilization. Option C, reduce the shipping and storage cost. Option D, all the above. Dear students, we have already seen the benefits that we are going to get out of good packing of goods during transportation. Packing plays a major role in the transportation. Hence, all the options listed here from A to C suits to the benefits of packing, and we can say option D, all the above, is correct for question number 3. Question number 4, optimizing the routes reduce the dash. Option A, transportation cost. Option B, insurance cost. Option C, demurrage charges. ऑप्शन डी कैपिटल कॉस्ट। यस स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन अबाउट रूटिंग। रूटिंग इज द सिलेक्शन पाथ फॉर द ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ऑफ गुड्स फ्रॉम द डिलीवरी स्टेशन टू द फ्रॉम द रिसीविंग स्टेशन टू द डिलीवरी स्टेशन। Hence, optimizing is an important criteria. It always saves the transportation cost from the point of receiving, and it decreases the transportation cost. Hence, we can say that option A, transportation cost will be reduced, is correct. Next, we'll go to the question number 5: the effect of delay in transportation. Option A, increased transportation cost. Option B, reduced productivity. Option C, reduces customer services. And option D, all the above. Dear students, we have already studied that delay is dependent on routing. Improper routing always causes the delay in transportation. This delay in transportation always reduces customer services, it increases transportation cost, as well it will reduce the productivity. Hence, with the delay, we have all the three impacts. We can say clearly that option D, all the above, is correct for question number 5. Next, question number 6. Dash cost includes insurance and taxes on inventory. Option A, inventory service cost. Option B, capital cost. Option C, storage space cost. Option D, inventory risk cost. We have seen that these are the inclusive of demurrage charges, which are paid for due detention of goods, undue detention of goods. So basically, the cost which includes insurance and taxes on inventory is inventory service cost. Hence, option A, inventory service cost, is correct for question number 6. Next question is, dash cost includes obsolescence, pilferage, relocation within the inventory system, and damage. Option A, inventory service cost. Option B, capital cost. Option C, storage space cost. Option D, inventory risk cost. Dear students, again, these are the costs which are inclusive of demurrage charges, and the cost which includes obsolescence, pilferage, relocation within the inventory system, and damage is inventory risk cost. Hence, option D, inventory risk cost, is correct. Next question. Insurance provides safety and security against the money tied with the materials. Is this statement true or false? Option A, true. Option B, false. Insurance, as we learned, that it is a system to provide safety and security against the money tied with the materials. Hence, we can clearly say that option A, true, is correct. Ninth question says, logistic activities are option A, customer service. Option B, demand forecasting. Option C, order processing. Option D, all the above. Dear students, these are the logistic activities we had learned in the complete supply chain management process in the components part of session 9. Hence, we can clearly say that all these are the activities included under logistics to control the raw materials till it is out for production. So option B, all the above is correct for question number 9. Question number 10. Forklift trucks, platform trucks, hand trucks, cranes and carts are the examples of dash. Option A, powered material handling. Option B, non-powered material handling. Option C, all the above. Both powered and non-powered material are the equipments we are using for material handling purpose, for the purpose of preparing the items for shipment to transport them into trucks. So here we are using both powered and non-powered item materials for handling this purpose. Hence option C, all the above is correct for question number 10. Question number 11, proper selection of routing helps to satisfy customer. Option A, true. Option B, false. Yes, it is very obvious that proper selection or the good routing always increases customer service and gain profit. Hence, this statement is true and we can say option A is correct. Question number 12, delays in transportation reduces customer services. Option A, true. Option B, false. Dear students, we already learned that delays in transportation always reduces customer services and it increases the material handling and maintenance cost as well. Hence, the statement given is true. Option A is correct. That's all for today, students. Hope you enjoyed the session. Have a great day. Thank you.